Venus in Virgo. A Venus in Virgo placement can feel very unlucky in love, and that's why it's not the greatest placement to have. Virgo is a servant. If you have Venus in Virgo, you can often feel like you will sacrifice everything when you are in love. It's like shackles. There's this feeling like you will give of yourself. There's no fantasy here. It's all in terms of sacrifice and servitude, really. So it's a very dangerous thing to fall in love if you are a Virgo placement here. They are often very distant, like a feeling like there's some walls up. And the reason for that is that with friends and family, romance, they give of themselves. And they assume that people are not always grateful, that things that they do will go unnoticed. Sometimes it does. And this will keep you distant. A feeling like you don't want to double down. You want to go very slowly into falling in love, not rush into anything. Love is not a flowery fantasy. Love is not just a few words. Love is an action. Someone to say something to you of how much they care about you doesn't mean much, if anything, to a Venus in Virgo position. You're not great at demanding credit, especially when it comes to someone you love. When you're in love with somebody, you want to do everything you can. You don't expect anything in return. You don't even expect them to notice or appreciate. And so you end up suffering in silence. Love, a thing that is so great for everyone else, seems like just pure torture to you, which is really a shame. A Venus in Virgo is actually so good at loving. Love really is a sacrifice. Love isn't about yourself feeling good. It's about giving of yourself to another. Sometimes people with this placement just shut their heart off completely because it is so draining. It just takes everything out of them. Love here is the ultimate sacrifice. So we're dealing with very scary stuff. You're really looking for the needle in the haystack, the diamond in the rough, the person who will have ultimate power to hurt another and to take advantage of another, and yet they won't. Someone that could take everything from the person that loves them, but they will love you just as much in return. And that's really what a Venus in Virgo is looking for. Someone who is just as willing to put themselves out on the railroad tracks, sacrifice everything that they have. If you find that person, that will be the ultimate romance for a Venus in Virgo. Sorry about the light. The sun is just setting right now. So even if you are in love as a Venus in Virgo, you will probably feel alone. The subtleties and the nuances and the details of who you are under the surface, often unnoticed. And to be known is to be loved. To be loved is to be known. While you can give love, Venus in Virgo is not always great at receiving love. Your heart is very independent. It doesn't need other people. You feel it's your role to give to the people that you love. Your heart is not really great at taking from the people that you love. You might think that that's you doing them a favor, but to the people that love you back, it will feel like the walls are just so high that they don't know how to get through. See, most people are great with taking. The Venus in Virgo, while it might be not the greatest placement to have, I think it is very lucky if you figure out the one thing of how to have your heart receive love back.
Light does change when it's the sun. Love here is not big and flashy. It's more like little pebbles or little grains of sand. And over time, it collects more and more and more. And that's how the love builds. That's how you know it's real. For a Venus in Virgo, a love story takes a very long time. You're looking for someone that appreciates you. You're looking for someone who notices how much sacrifice you make. You're looking for someone who doesn't want you to be a martyr, but who wants you to be enjoying as well as giving. Someone who notices all the little details, just like you do. Someone that isn't wrapped up in themselves, doesn't think of love selfishly. You're looking for someone who is looking for a quiet heart. If they're not discerning, they might think you're heartless. But really, your heart is very big. It's just very quiet and goes unnoticed. Someone that doesn't mind your fascination with the mundane. You know that within the details is the truth. It's not in the big sweeping love stories, because in a 2-hour movie, there's all of these little moments in between that we don't see. And that's where the real life is. And that's where the real special moments are. And that's what a Virgo is all about. If you are a man with this position, you're probably looking for someone that they don't always express everything. The emotion is very quiet and giving. It's very mature. Someone who's immature is a real big turnoff to you. A man with a Venus in Virgo is not going to have a torrid affair usually. It's funny because this is the kind of lustful position, because Venus is all about attraction and lust. And yet here, this man is attracted to qualities that are not quick, but slow and steady. An understated beauty. When I think of this position, I think of Mr. Big in Sex and the City. Because it's a person who seems kind of heartless, a person who seems like they're kind of cold, and they've got their walls up. But really, if you finally win them over after a very, very long time, then they are the ultimate. And they are so giving. A man here is looking for a natural beauty, someone who doesn't try too hard. It's just effortless. Because natural is real. A man here is looking for somebody who's cool as a cucumber, very intelligent, clean and organized, a level of sophistication, not needy and clingy. She doesn't have a lot of gross habits. Probably perfect hygiene is a great turn on here. A woman that takes care of herself. You don't have to take care of her because she is already doing it. She's probably a woman that can wear white all day and not get a single stain. She's always on time. She seems to be able to just handle everything like she's gliding through life. Usually someone who has Venus in Virgo loves a clean house. They love old-fashioned etiquette. They love classic music and art. They like to be very put together in public. No crazy signs of drama. They don't want to show their emotions in public usually. They can be very hard to read, even by friends that know them for a long time. Reserved, seeming secretive almost. They don't want to always show what they're feeling. And also they're self-contained. They don't really need friends. They don't call and complain and tell you all the drama of their lives because they usually handle it internally. As a friend, they're very dependable though because they are self-contained. They have friends that probably need them more than they need the friends. For a woman here, she's probably very critical. She pays attention to all the little details, including in bed. She's like the monkey that picks off all the little fleas of her lover. And this can be very annoying to someone that doesn't want someone to see every little weakness and every little detail. But she does. If I were to picture this sign as a Roman statue, I'd probably picture the Venus in Virgo as a person that's washing the feet of their lover. Because it's all about sacrifice, giving of yourself when you're in love. Home is their retreat. Home is their perfect world. And a Venus in Virgo usually needs a lot of time at home to decompress and to heal their heart because they're self-healing. They need time to purify. They have their own heart purifier. Everyone else needs friends for that. If somebody that has a Venus in Virgo is in love, they will show you by acting. They will do something to show you how much they love you. Words are never enough. They want to make your life better. They will help you in a real way. Could be paying for your startup company, could be giving you a massage, could be organizing your sock drawer, or all the above. This is the friend that doesn't always express how much you mean to them through words, but they do it through helping you move or taking you to the airport or all of those things that all the other friends just magically aren't available. Your message goes to voicemail whenever you really need somebody, except the Venus in Virgo. And this is also the friend that's going to be there bright and early. They're usually not late, and they value your time as well as their own. Respect is the turn on. It is the attraction. If you have this position, it probably takes you a long time to loosen up. Somehow you make even romance organized. Usually they're very level-headed about love until they reach the point of no return, and then there is no turning back. If you have this position, be careful not to analyze love to death, because then it will become very stale. You guys are more sensitive than you show. Success is often a big turn-on. You can really make a difference in people's lives, but be careful not to become a martyr. There are always two sides to the coin, no matter how self-contained your heart really is. Just think of receiving love as a great skill you have to learn. To a Venus in Virgo, two friends that are real friends always trumps a big, huge room of friends.
That's my take on Venus in Virgo. Come back for the next video. Subscribe.